In this video, I'm going to show you how to assess regional and segmental intervertebral motion of the mid and lower thoracic spine in flexion. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. Passive assessment of the quantity and quality of segmental intervertebral motion, also known as motion palpation, is part of the diagnostic clinical expertise of manual practitioners to guide decisions on a therapeutic strategy for patients with spinal pain. Hypermobility indicates mobilizing interventions, while hypermobility calls for a stabilizing approach. A study done by Walker et al. In the year 2015 evaluated the reliability of passive segmental assessment of the thoracic spine on restricted and painful segments and found only poor to low level agreement between the raters. For this reason, the clinical value of passive thoracic spine assessment is weak. In order to perform regional range of motion assessment for mid and lower thoracic flexion of vertebrae T5 till T12, have your patient sit upright at the edge of the bench, while the examiner stands on the contralateral side to be examined. The bench height should be adjusted so that your patient's shoulder is a little bit lower than your own. Then ask your patient to cross his arms in front of his chest and establish contact with the patient's back on the contralateral side. Fixate your patient's vertebrae L1 with your thena eminence into ventrocaudal direction and let him slouch a little bit until you feel that L1 wants to move. Then perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of flexion, ipsilateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation. This movement causes maximal opening of the facet joints on the thoracic spine on the contralateral side. The whole movement is judged on resistance during motion and at end range, range of motion, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the other side. In order to continue with segmental assessment of, say, T9 and T10, have your patient sit straight again, fixate spinous process of T10 with your thena eminence, and have your patient slightly slouch against this fixation. Then perform a maximal homonymous 3D movement with equal components of flexion, ipsilateral, lateral flexion, and ipsilateral rotation again. To test each component of intervertebral motion, slightly move out of the end range, and now test flexion between T9 and T10 by pushing the spinous process of T10 ventrocaudally with your thena eminence. To assess rotation, move on to the ipsilateral transverse process of T10 and be aware that the transverse process is about 1 to 2 centimeters higher than the spinous process in the thoracic spine, and then move it ventrally with your thena eminence or thumb. For lateral flexion, place your thumb ipsilaterally between the spinous process of T9 and T10 and move your patient's thoracic spine into lateral flexion with your upper arm. Each component is judged on resistance during motion and feel, as well as possible pain provocation compared to the segment above or below. Alright, this was our video on intervertebral motion assessment of mid and lower thoracic flexion. If you want to learn how to assess intervertebral motion of the upper thoracic spine in flexion, click on the video right next to me. As always, thank you very much for watching. Feel free to give this video a like and share it if you liked it. If you want to see more of us, check us out on our other social media channels for all of our videos, including articles, statistical values, and more. Have a look at our very own assessment ebook and app. Links can be found in the description down below. This was Kai for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.